Hey guys. So I'm currently at Lowe's right now. I'm currently at Lowe's right now so I can start scratching my leg. So I can start window shopping for stuff that I'm gonna need for the van as far as build is concerned. Now, of course, in my head, I really wanted to do something like super intricate. Like, I was pretty much planning on going to the extreme as far as my build is concerned. But I think for my first conversion, I should probably stick to the basics and keep it simple, especially since I have to consider weight. And I know like certain tires can only carry up to a certain weight. I want to make sure, I think the one that I want to have probably only carries up to about 9,000. It'll only be able to carry about 9,000 pounds. So I need to make sure that I don't go over that. Which also means I need to go find like a weighing station, which I know where the closest one is. It's about an hour actually of a drive from here, but more like 45 minutes. It's just before Orlando. But yeah, so I have plans to just go ahead and go inside. So come with me. I'm inside of Lowe's and I'm looking around. I'm not really in a particular area. I'm in the lawnmower area. And lights. Ooh. Lights. Oh, what if I have black lights inside? Oh, those are for fish tanks. The like purpley. Wait, where am I? Okay, well, I don't know where you are. Oh my god! Okay, so guys, let me just tell you what just happened. So, I accidentally dropped my phone, and for the first time, I cracked the screen. I've dropped this phone on its face 5 million times and nothing has ever happened. And now I officially have a cracked screen. So it's a sign that I should be looking for a new phone soon. I want those up there, but I think that's for fish tanks, but maybe not. I guess I could still technically use them. Not fish tanks, for plants. Whatever, it says grow light. Oh. Cracked my screen. Alright, so, have a couple of... Rude? Okay, so... Oh, I should be going over here looking at little sinks, but maybe I should wait until after I actually get to that point of build. I need to be thinking about just walls right now. But anyhow, guys, I have a couple of ideas for the look that I want to go for, and I've always had this dream about having a gothic inspired bedroom, and I realize that I now have the opportunity to do that if I get this van. I can convert it and literally have my own style without feeling concerned about, oh, if I drill a hole in the wall, I'll have to pay for it when I try to leave this place, blah, 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 blah. Literally, mine's completely. Currently looking at sinks right now. Okay, I don't know why. Like that, sorry about that. It's just, you know, people. So, it's too early for me to be looking at these, but I figured I might as well get an idea of the kind of sink setup that I would need. I know for sure that if I do decide to put, well, actually, I will have a sink setup because I want to be able to brush my teeth without having to actually leave my place. So I would basically need like a pump kind of sink, you know, where you like pump the water, because that's the system I'm going to be going with, pumping system. And I know, I was thinking about getting like a 5 gallon RV water tank, which will be placed underneath the sink. It's just a matter of finding Okay, see, the problem with these things is that none of them are pumps. They're all just regular. I'm probably just not in the right area. Maybe there are other little. Or maybe that might be something that I would have to order. Whatever, no big deal. It's too early in the game, anyways, for me to be concerned about that. But, yeah. It's a little too early for me to be concerned about that. Anyway, so let's go take a look at. I know I need to figure out insulation and. By the way, sorry if I'm giving you a lot of chin acne action. Oh! Now that's gonna be important. Because when I do my sink, I want. Obviously, I was actually thinking. I know a lot of people tend to go with copper sinks, but I was actually thinking something a little bit more lightweight. So, I mean, it's a little expensive, but you see this little glass situation here? I really like that. That's really pretty, and I think it will go very well with my idea, my design, if I go with the gothic look. But then I was also thinking, ooh, actually, whoa, that's kind of heavy. That's a little bit heavier than. Oh, that's heavier than I thought it would be. But it's so pretty, and I should have what I want because I tend to live my life not allowing myself to have hardly any of the things that I want, which is terrible. Which I'm pretty sure is probably a trigger, and not realizing that I'm triggering myself occasionally. Could go with a round sink if I find one. A really nice one, though. Either way, it's got to have a pumping system. What am I talking about? Literally nothing. I'm just babbling my mouth, and you're like, Gabby, if you've got nothing important to say, just like turn off the camera. But my do what I want. Well, we need to be thinking about walls, and I'm not in the right area because I'm so distracted by literally everything that I see. Oh, toilets. Okay, so I haven't decided yet if I'm gonna have like an actual working toilet in my van in my van because I don't know if I really want to go through that whole dumping situation, but I know that let's say I'm on the road and I happen to pass that line where there are no stop stations forever and I can't hold it. I do need to have like a portable toilet of sorts. So, I was actually thinking, because I've seen a couple people do this, I was actually thinking about using the whole kitty litter situation. And so you have like a little makeshift toilet and in the tank at the bottom where everything goes through. That's pretty. It pretty much goes into where you have the kitty litter and then you just clean that out whenever you can make a stop. And most people have it set up to where there is no smell in your van, and that's something that concerns me, smells, because I am so convinced that I'm a smelly person and I just don't want to add to what I think I smell like. So yeah. This is so pretty. Holy cow, this is a shower. Wow. Wow, I like this. I've seen people install showers in their vans. I would. I think this is heavy though, but I have to make sure I look at the vans first because I'm starting to look at things that I can't have. But these are such beautiful showers, like. Well, I did see a couple that did manage to install a shower in their van. It's a really tiny one. Granted, they're not fat like I am, so they could fit into that fucking shower. I probably wouldn't be able to fit. But basically, they made theirs, I'm just gonna say Japanese style, where you shower, brush your teeth, and poop all in the same place. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, just look it up. It's not as gross and weird as it sounds. I swear to you, it's really not. It's actually really cool. It's a very good idea. And in my opinion, it kind of keeps the place clean if you're also showering in that spot. But that's an idea, maybe. Because I would like to not have to use my gym membership too much. Because I always feel bad because I have to wait till a specific time. And sometimes, like, I do things where I get dirty. Like, we did paintball, and I got dirty, and I didn't want to wait till the middle of the night to go take a shower. But I went right into the gym, took my shower, and came back out, but I could tell that, you know, I was basically being stared at, because the gym that I go to is so intimate. Everybody knows who you are when you walk in, even if you don't want them to know who you are. And that's the thing that's irritating. Alright, so I'm in the flooring area, because I definitely need to get an idea of what I'm going to do with floors. When I get my van, if I can qualify for the trade-in to actually get the van, because I know that there are certain circumstances that'll cause me to have to pay money out of pocket if my car is worth less, which it shouldn't because it's a new car, than what I'm paying for. It's like some kind of red tape when it comes to trading in vehicles for a car for another vehicle that might be more expensive or less. Anyway, so I really want to have carpet, but I realize the maintenance is going to be a little bit too much as far as vacuuming, and I won't be as discreet. So I'm going to go with maybe faux wood. No, that's not what it's called at the moment. I can't think of the name, and I'm currently in the tile section, which is not what we're looking for here. We're not looking for tiles. They're really nice tiles, though. But really, really prefer carpet. I prefer carpet. But I think what I'll do is I'll just probably get laminate, I think that's what it's called. I'll get like laminate flooring, and then I'll probably just go ahead and get a rug to put over it in like certain areas, like where the bed is gonna be. Oh, this, there we go. Porcelain? Oh, that's porcelain.
I'm gonna go down this way, but you decide to straighten up there, and I'll come back to you.
Great, so let's see. Ooh, peel and stick. Oh, okay, guys, so.
You want to get back in the buggy? Get back in here, then. You want to get back in? And then come on and push it together.
Alright, so. That's a good idea for, like, the wall part of my kitchen, actually. Getting distracted again. Alright, so. I'm gonna go with a gothic theme. I have to think more dark colors. So that wouldn't really be the right. This definitely wouldn't be the right color scheme for. Well, actually, I can make that work. I'm just too lazy to make that work, but I can make that work. However, this one would be a little bit better. I just wish it didn't have that white in there. And I don't see any other variations. Wish it didn't have that white in there. I might just go to Home Depot afterwards just to see if they have like a better selection of colors, but yeah. Okay, this would be nice. Except this is not the peel and stick. I'd rather do a peel and stick than to actually have to glue every piece in. But this would work. If I can get something in that color, but in the peel form, then it would be perfect. Something like that, or maybe this. This is like a metallic color. That would work too. What's over here? That's nice. Kind of like that. I don't even know if this is showing up well, because I can't see the camera right now. But I like that. That's nice. I also like this coral here. I just call it coral. Anyways, minty color here. It's pretty nice. Oh, I should have not come into this little section. Oh my god. I'm seeing things that I love that. This, holy shit. This is, oh my god. That's probably the best one. That's definitely the best one. Ooh, if I can get that in a peel and stick, that would be perfect. Oh my god. Okay, so I don't know if I already mentioned this. I repeat myself a lot, so I'm sorry if I repeat myself again, but the reason why I'm looking for a peel and stick is, actually there are two reasons. A, I just don't want to spend all the time trying to make a wall. I want to keep it simple, and B, weight is a problem. I have to make sure that I keep the weight under control when it comes to this build. So after I figure out what I can actually get, next week, I can then start deciding how heavy my design can be. Wow, they've got so many beautiful things here. So many ideas that are like just flawlessly beautiful. Holy shit. Anyways, I need to start looking at like, oh, here we go, floors. Wood, but it's like wood. I need like non-wood wood. Laminate. So I was looking at the tutorials on how to actually install the insulation. It was exactly what I thought it would be. It's kind of weird that I already sort of had the knowledge. It's not that it's weird, actually. It's really not that it's weird. My former stepdad, actually, is a carpenter and an electrician and stuff. So, and I used to go with him, me and my brother, whenever he would build houses and stuff like that. So I kind of got used to seeing him do it, him and his friends and his coworkers or whatever. Also, my uncle is also a carpenter, and so I'm kind of used to it. Oh, here we go. Found my laminates. Laminate flooring. Yeah. I'll see you guys in the next clip.